It's The Local Show on News Radio 570 WSYR, a service of Safe Harbor Wills and Trusts and Geddes Federal Savings and Loan. The Local Show, featuring conversations with business owners, employees, and local business leaders about their successes, challenges, and reasons for doing business right here in Central New York. The Local Show is locally produced by Zoey Advertising. Now, your hosts, Tom and Steve.
Back into it. Back at it. And you've got The Local Show, the last bastion of really good talk radio on the weekends.
If you say so, Tom.
That's right. It's hour number two, Steve. So lock in and get ready for some engaging interviews with Vittorio Pascarella. He is the vice president of Pascarella Development and Management. Bud Laura stops by. He's the owner of Restaurant QB. John Kupperman is the owner of Smith Restaurant Supply. And Christina Farrar is the education coordinator for New York State Maple Association. We'll find out all about Maple Weekends, which is just around
coming
the corner.
Up. Pretty sweet.
We're broadcasting from the Zoey Advertising Studio, sponsored by Safe Harbor Wills and Trusts and Geddes Federal Savings and Loan. We're also on YouTube if you want to peek behind the curtain and see what everybody looks like and, you know, if Steve picks his nose and all that. So.
Zoey Advertising on YouTube. I think they assigned us a different number on that, Tom. There was a number.
3809.
Yeah, I think it changed. I think it might have changed.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was looking.
I should know that.
And I saw something different. So if you go to Zoey Advertising, you can see it all and other stuff that Zoey does and different things. But you can get a good look at Tom and say, wow, I listen to this guy?
Yeah. Well, right now it's our pleasure to bring on Vittorio Pascarella. He's the vice president of Pascarella Development and Management. Now, Vittorio, isn't that, you know, don't we call you Vito?
Vito's good. Thank you for having me, by the way.
Sure. Is that an Irish name?
Yeah, a little bit. So I usually give out the name Vito because Vittorio is too many syllables for most people to pronounce. But you nailed it.
Good.
You nailed it.
Well, that's what I thought it might be Vito. So anyway, Vito, what's your story, man? What do you do and why are you here?
A whole lot of nothing lately. Just work. We recently acquired the Will & Bomber Candle Factory right off of Onondaga Lake Parkway, and it's been engulfing most of our time for probably the last 3 years leading up to this. A lot of preparation and a lot of construction.
Now you're not old enough. You're not old enough to remember, but I remember driving by there when it was active.
It was really cool looking. And if we came down from, I grew up in Cicero.
Yeah.
There were no Italians in Cicero. When I came down from Cicero, I would look for the candle, the smokestack with the candle. Right. I would look for that because I thought that was the landmark.
Cool. Yeah.
Funny. And you saved it, right? Still there?
Yeah. The previous owner was pretty close to knocking it down, and what a catastrophe it would have been. But it's, I start out by telling everybody everything that I can about the project, and I don't even know if half the time people listen to what I'm saying. They just kind of zone into that candle stack and ask me what's going to happen with it. But we have a couple interesting ideas that we're floating around. Cool. Not there yet.
So what is your company, and how did you get involved with that?
So we're a property management / construction company. My father started out as a contractor some 30 years ago now. Mm-hmm. My mother was a hairdresser, had a shop down on East Division Street. He renovated it, and there were three rental units up top. And little by little, the construction company turned into a property management company. Acquisitions took place, remodels, and we're kind of coming back to our roots where we were at 30 years ago, getting more into the construction end and kind of developing our own units as opposed to buying up older units and rehabilitating them. This is sort of a rehabilitation on steroids.
So you look at this old factory, probably has environmental issues, been around forever.
Looks like a huge undertaking.
Who had the vision to make that into apartments? And you'll tell us about
tell us
what
it's going to
be.
So we're looking at about 175 apartments.
Wow.
In total. Wow. Two new buildings. There's going to be a brewery that we hope to open up this spring.
Nice.
So we have a good team of brewers that we brought on board as good collective partners. Mm-hmm. And we have some exciting things. That's actually where the brewery is going to be located, is the we call it the boiler house.
Okay.
So every building sort of has its own story, and that's that's the way we're going to approach it. You know, that first iconic brick building, right. We refer to that as the mansion. Mm-hmm. And then the big concrete structure next door to it, we refer to that as the factory. Okay. So, I mean, the site's a lot bigger than what it looks like from the road.
And, yeah, I don't think a lot of people have gone into it.
No,
you know?
No, it's a 13-acre site. And to answer your previous question, as far as where all these ideas come from, collectively with the team that we have, I'd like to take credit for everything. I can't do that. We're a family-owned and operated business, and mother, brother, father, aunts, uncles,
right,
and everybody that works with us, we kind of look at as family. We have a great team. Of people helping us out.
So climb inside. So, what are the apartments going to be like?
Awesome.
Really? Yeah, tell me more.
So that first building, they're 13-foot ceilings, concrete deck, exposed ductwork, sort of industrial feel. Very, very efficient units. You're going to have your in-house laundry right inside your apartment. You're going to have underground parking, covered parking. Each tenant's going to get one of those. Mm-hmm. Included with their fees. You're going to have your electricity included. You're going to have your heat included. You're going to have your internet included.
How about safety?
Safety,
included.
Security. Yep, included. Safety included. Yeah, no. That's right.
It's going to be secure.
There's a trash service. Yeah, there's a trash service right inside the building. Nice. You have to go outside in the middle of winter to drop your trash off. We come in, we go to a centrally located room on each floor, pick up the trash, drop it off in the trash chute for you.
Fitness center?
Fitness center will be later on down the road.
Okay.
So that's one of the mixed use elements that we're planning on implementing as a fitness center.
Right. Will it be cost prohibitive?
It sounds expensive.
Yeah, it sounds expensive.
Not at all. Once you add up the cost of your rent and you include your utilities and your internet and your laundry and your underground parking, I think we're going to be very competitive in this market.
It's a wonderful location. And I said that to the wife the other day because she had mentioned that was going to be rehabilitated, not knowing that I was going to do this interview. Yeah.
No, it really is. It's central to everything. It's downtown living in the suburbs, if you think of it like that. I mean, and that's the feel. Once that brewery goes up and the new building in front of the site goes up, you're going to be in your own little gated community. Will and Bobber's Urban Villages is kind of what we've been floating.
Yeah.
And it really is. It's like an urban setting in the middle of the suburbs.
What's the timeline for these things?
This summer, we're hoping to get the first units up and running, 20 units.
Okay. Will you have to change the traffic pattern at all in the road? Did you have to work with the town?
We're looking into that. We have plans to get another access further on down Park Street. Right now, we can be operational with what we have.
With what you got.
Yeah. In the later phases, we're going to get another access point opened.
Sure.
God willing. Later on this year.
And you are able to get off there. You come around the corner. Yeah. It's kind of wide. It isn't,
Right.
It's not that bad.
And if you started off over by 7th North, you could even come down.
Correct.
The road. It was challenging to find a solution to get into the site, but we think we got it nailed down pretty good once the full plans are implemented. So.
And there's a lot of trees over there too, so you can still give it that park-like feel.
Oh yeah. There's going to be a big courtyard that we're going to add more trees. And towards the perimeter of the property. So, you really feel...
Boy, Steve, that could be... Well, that has your name written all over it.
Right? I live in an apartment up northern Onondaga County. Yeah. We scaled down from the house, and when we went looking, there were different things. And I have a garage, and I can pull all the things you mentioned are important.
Right. Well, at brewery. He had me at brewery.
Because I want it to be simple. I want it to be simple. And what I heard you saying is, it's going to be really nice, but a simple place to live.
Yeah.
And is the website pdm-llc.com?
Yeah, that's our main website. Once we get closer to being operational with this property, we're going to set up another system.
And if someone wanted information or looking ahead, the 457-1305?
Absolutely.
So write that down, 457-1305, and you can get information about, if someone has a lease expiring in the fall, hey, what would it be and what are you going to have? They can have that conversation.
Absolutely.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much, and thank you to your family as well for putting this kind of a project together in our community. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having us, and I appreciate the kind words.
Excellent.
We love it.
Okay. Bud Laura is coming up next. He's the owner of Restaurant QB. We'll find out all about his business on the local show on 570 WSYR.